end of this one, it is centered here. These are the two hydrogen atoms. They are far apart from each other. There is no overlap between the two wave functions. When you combine them into a molecule, what will happen? That the plus here, this plus are now closer to each other, and now plot their wave functions. So you are having wave function like this and its wave function like this, right? And this range is the overlapping range. This is the exchange range. Clear? They are far apart from each other. They are two individual atoms, hydrogen atom. When you brought them closer to each other, now their wave functions are overlapping here. And when they are overlapping, we will apply, means this overlapping term will now be non-zero, right? The overlapping term will be non-zero here. When they are non-overlapping, then this term is equal to zero. Clear? When the wave functions are not overlapping, you are having this integral equal to zero. And in non-overlapping wave functions, now the electrons are distinguishable, are behaving like distinguishable particles. While in the overlap wave functions, they are now identical. You cannot differentiate the electron of this one from the electron of this one. So what will happen in this overlap? That our two electrons are now in the overlap, here and here. So the negative charge density is now between the two nuclei. You see, the two electrons are here. So the negative charge density is between the two nuclei. And what will happen? That this proton is attracted towards the nuclear, the electronic density, the negative charge density. And this proton is also attracted towards this one. And what will happen? The two nuclei are the two atoms will experience attraction toward each other. Right? And we will say that in this overlap, our wave functions are actually attracting each other. Our nuclei are our protons are attracting each other. Now, what's another possibility? Another possibility is that one electron come here and the other electron is here. This is another possibility. Means I am ignoring all the intermediate one, but the two ends I am discussing. When the electron is like this, so the proton is having attraction, or the nucleus attraction is here and is here. And in the middle, what will happen? Now there is no screening of the repulsion, because the negative charge density was screening the repulsion between proton and proton. Now these are not here, and what will happen? One proton will be repelling the other proton, and their separation will be increasing. The atomic separation will be increasing, and you will not be able to form a hydrogen molecule. Clear? You will not be able to form a hydrogen molecule. So when the force is attracted, hydrogen molecule is formed. And when hydrogen molecule is formed, you call that thing bonding. And in chemistry, you are turning such, when the electrons are not, you can say, transferring, but only the overlap is causing some attraction. You call the sharing of electrons. You call such a bonding as covalent bonding. And in this situation, when the electrons distribution is on, you can say, the two sides, we may have a repulsion between proton and proton, and we call this thing as anti bonding, and there will be no covalent bonding. This wave function combination, which is causing you bonding, is symmetric wave function, and which is causing you anti bonding is actually anti symmetric wave function. Clear? Anti symmetric wave function. So when the overlap of the two is symmetric, you will have attraction, and when the overlap is antisymmetric, you will have repulsion. This, so far we have discussed the spatial wave function, the wave function which is dependent on R1 and R2 of the particle, which we call the spatial wave function. But we know that two electrons, when they are in the overlap state, the Pauli exclusion principle says that the two electrons cannot be in the same state with the same set of quantum numbers. So it means the electrons are not bosons, they are fermions. And we will have to differentiate over here. The reason is that we are ignoring another property associated with this electron. This is the half thing that we are discussing here, which is the spatial wave function. We are not including the spinner, which is not a wave function, which is not the space dependent, but it is actually the spinner chi. And this spinner is including the property of the spin of the electron. So we will have to include spin as well here. Clear? Okay, let me repeat this thing so that before the inclusion of the spin, we understand the whole situation again. Come here. This is the term which is coming from the overlap of the wave functions. Why the wave functions are overlapping? Because the particles are identical particles, and we cannot recognize them, that which particle is which. For example, you come here. The two wave functions, means wave function this one and this one, overlapped. Now if the electron of this atom comes here and the electron of this atom comes here, we will not come to know, because the particles are identical particles. So this overlap is generating this term, right? Clear? Now come to the problem of symmetric and antisymmetric. When you will have plus sign here, it will be symmetric. Look here, the things will be symmetric. And when minus sign is here, so the minus here, forget about this minus plus that we are having here. When here will be plus, we will have symmetric wave function. And when here will be minus, we will have antisymmetric wave function. For the fermions, we are having minus here, and this is opposite. For the bosons, we are having minus, and for the fermions we are having plus. But we will have to switch it to the symmetric and antisymmetric. Means when it is plus here, this is symmetric wave function. When it is minus here, this is antisymmetric wave function. So, not only the spatial wave function is to be symmetric, means we said that when the wave function is symmetric, we will have attraction. And when the wave function will be antisymmetric, we will have repulsion, antibonding. Yes. Come here. This one, this wave function is symmetric. Because here we are having the plus sign here. And this singlet state is antisymmetric. Yes. When this one, this is antisymmetric. And now come here that we only considered the spatial wave function, symmetric and antisymmetric. But what about this one? What about the spinner? The spinner is also symmetric and antisymmetric. So we will have now a combined wave function, which we call the total wave function of the two particles state, and the total wave function will be psi of r and chi. And this I can write for the two particle state is psi r1 r2 and chi 1 2, particle 1 and particle 2. So, when this will work, only that if the exchange occurs in these two, means the net result is antisymmetric. And look here, when it is psi r1, r2, and this is chi 1, 2. If this is equal to minus, means minus sign comes out, and this is R2, R1, and this is chi, this is 2, 1. So what you will call this thing is the total exchange is now antisymmetric. So if you are having this one symmetric, if you are having this one symmetric, then this should be antisymmetric. So the overall result will be antisymmetric. And if this one is antisymmetric, then this should be symmetric. So the ball exclusion principle is here. Understand this one. We are having attraction. Here means the bonding. Here we know the bonding is occurring. The bonding is occurring between a hydrogen atom and hydrogen atom, and it is forming hydrogen molecule. Covalent bonding is occurring, and the wave function is symmetric. This was the example of symmetric wave function. So the wave function is symmetric. Then what about the spin of it? The spin should be antisymmetric, and the spin is antisymmetric only in this one, not in this one. So if the wave function is symmetric, then the fermions should be in the singlet state. Otherwise, it is not possible to keep into account the Pauli exclusion principle. If this one is antisymmetric, then this one should be symmetric. It will be from the spin states, will be from one of them. Clear? So the overall result will be antisymmetric, and this will work only. Spatial wave function symmetric, the spinner will be antisymmetric, means only the singlet state. If the electrons will be in the singlet state, covalent bonding will occur. And if this is antisymmetric, then this the spinner configuration will be from one of the triplet state, and then the bonding will occur. Clear? So we are having the exchange forces like this that we discussed. We looked into the basis of the bonding and anti-bonding here. One thing you will have to clarify that we are dealing here with the electrons, not with the bosons. The electrons are actually fermions, and fermions we send over there, that for the fermions the plus sign indicates that the fermions are going apart from each other. What we are doing here, we are bringing the fermions closer to each other. So in order to bring them closer to each other, the one situation that we are discussing only for the spatial wave function is not sufficient. We will have to look at the whole picture, and the whole picture is that when we combine the spin with it as well. So this function was not symmetric, but we were considering it symmetric and then they were coming closer. So it is becoming antisymmetric due to the spin. So the spin becomes here with it, and here this spin state when combines with it, then this condition will be satisfied. The product of them should be antisymmetric, not of the one symmetric and antisymmetric, or of the other symmetric and antisymmetric. Means you will take the whole picture, and when the whole picture will become symmetric or antisymmetric, then you will say that the condition is satisfied. This one, if this one is symmetric, this one should be antisymmetric. If this one is symmetric, this one should be antisymmetric.